how much different it is to charge an iPhone 6 Plus using its built-in 5-watt charger compared to the Apple 12-watt USB power adapter. My first idea was to measure using an outlet wattmeter, which is great, but it also measures the energy wasted by the charger as heat. So I bought the Drok Pocket Digital Multimeter USB to measure just what was going to the iPhone. It is super cool because it monitors the actual USB voltage, the current being drawn, calculating the watts and the accumulated transferred power. The tests started with totally depleted zero battery, dead iPhone, up to its full charge, taking notes every 10 minutes. Let's begin with the 5-watt charger that comes with the iPhone 6. This time lapse captured one frame every 8 seconds. I tried to reproduce the most usual charging scenario. I don't know anyone who really turns off the iPhone every night to charge, so here everything is on, including Wi-Fi and Bluetooth. The exception is the screen. Every 10 minutes, I quickly pressed the home button to check how much the battery was already charged. I always waited the screen to go off again. Then I wrote the information being shown on the meter. The reason is, there is a current increase when the screen is on, which is totally different when the screen is off and the phone is idle, just charging. The next day, completely empty battery, I did the same thing all over again, now using the 12-watt charger. The iPhone then draws more current with this charger, but it only gets closer to 1.9 amps when the screen was turned on. The current starts to decrease. And after 80%, it slows down a lot. Let's just wait it to finish and I will show you the curve in a nice chart. Here it is, how the iPhone 6 Plus charges on 5 watts and how it charges on a 12-watt charger. But it could be the 10-watt brick as well, it never passed 10 watts. So, it is clear that the 5-watt charger provided in the box with the iPhone 6 Plus and also the iPhone 6 and 6S and 6S Plus is less than ideal. A 10-watt would be the ideal charger. If you are in a hurry, the bigger brick can charge to 70% in 70 minutes. The 5-watt charger takes 2 hours to do the same. I found really cool that, charging with the 5-watt brick, I got a bigger accumulated transfer, which makes sense. In the first case, the iPhone was connected during 3 hours and 45 minutes. On the second case, only for 2 hours and a half. Remember, the iPhone was turned on, so more time connected, more energy. I did these tests as a research for this other video. I am pretty sure you will love it. Thumbs up if you enjoyed this video and subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching.